Hi friends, welcome to Hashtag Me. Today in this topic we'll see about Metaspace Java. It is a case study. So Metaspace is topic that is related to memory aspect in Java 8. It's actually an improvement to the previous memory aspect. So let's see what do you mean by Metaspace one by one. And do keep liking, subscribing, Hashtag Me. Move to come on your Java related topics and other technology topics. Let's move now. So Metaspace definition and key aspects. In Java, it basically PermGen area method are replaced with Metaspace. Specialized memory in native OS called as Metaspace. So it would be separate for the Linux, separate for Windows, separate for Mac, separate for other kind of OS. So it's specialized memory space that is according to native OS. That's Metaspace. So the main improvements over PermGen space is in the terms of garbage collection, auto-tuning of thread, concurrent deallocation of metadata. So these are the main key improvements. Metaspace size and max metaspace. So we can basically set the upper bounds in metaspace size and max metaspace. The main metaspace free ratio. What is that? It is the minimum percent of class metadata capacity free after garbage collection. Whenever JVM performs garbage collection, it is the minimum percentage of class metadata that it will remain free and unallocated after garbage collection. After that, we have max metaspace free ratio. This is the maximum percentage of class metadata capacity free after garbage collection to avoid reduction in amount of space. So when you want to achieve the maximum percent of free metadata after garbage collection to reduction in amount of space, we should go for max metaspace free ratio. Let's move on. So now you should take into consideration that is the key differences between Metaspace and PermGen space. So as I told that Metaspace is an introduction with Java 8. So previous to that we were having PermGen space. So the major differences are PermGen always has a fixed maximum size. Yeah, that is point number one. That is PermGen, you can't set beyond a specific maximum size from there. It has in the Metaspace by default auto increases its set date depending on our underlying OS. So it will take the consideration into the requirement of memory, and if it's not able to satisfy, it will automatically increase the size of the memory, which is not possible in the case of PermGen space. Memory in form of contiguous heap memory. So memory is in the form of contiguous heap memory in PermGen space. Whereas in Metaspace, we have native memory provided by underlying OS, as I explained earlier. Frequently, GC process and now concurrent deallocation of memory. That is in the case of PermGen space. In Metaspace, deallocate class data concurrently and not during GC pause. That is the key point. So during GC pause, deallocation class data concurrently is not done. And deallocation of class data concurrently is done after that. So, but in PermGen space, frequently there are GC pauses and concurrent deallocation of memory is not possible. So, also it's removed from Java 8 and above version PermGen space. It's included in Java 8 and above versions Metaspace. So, basically, in these we saw the fixed points about the size, the underlying OS, memory form. And it's how the memory is freed, the way of freeing it. Now let's move further. So these were the key differences. Now to get a detailed understanding to this Metaspace, you should know what is basically a Java JVM memory structure like. So as you can see in front of the diagram, so JVM defines various runtime areas that are divided into multiple memory like heap area. This is basically a heap area. After that we have method area. After that we have JVM stack. After that we have native method stack. After that we have PC register. So basically the entire area is divided into these sections like heap may contain only heap related memory. Method area means method related data is stored over there. JVM stack, stack related data is stored in JVM stack. Native method stack, some native method operations are stored in native method stack. And also we have PC register. So these are the main Java memory area parts that you should take into consideration. So let's move further. Now the key point is heap memory. So the heap memory is basically divided into young generation and old generation. So young generation nursery, so all the new objects are allocated in this memory. Whenever this memory gets filled, the garbage collection is performed. This is called a minor garbage collection. So the point to keep it noted, whenever new objects or newly created objects are allocated in memory, they are a part of young generation or nursery, as a literal English meaning you might get to know that newly objects are nothing but young generation and they are nursery. Old generations are nothing but all the long-lived objects which have survived several rounds of garbage collection are specially stored here. So maybe they have not been garbage collected since many rounds of garbage collections are performed. So they form a part of older generation. This is called as minor garbage, major garbage collection. It's a mistake. It's basically major garbage collection and young generation is minor garbage collection. So as you see in front of the diagram, in the light green you have younger generation, dark green you have old generation, and permanent generation, that is PermGen, on heap area. This is basically heap area is divided into young generation and old generation, and PermGen, that is non-heap area, that is one constituent of the memory, that is basically the heap memory. Let's move further. So as you saw in the diagram, so this was the heap memory. What there are issues related to PermGen memory. This is a special space in Java heap which is separated from the main memory, where all the static content is stored in this section. Apart from that, this memory also stores the application metadata required by JVM. So basically the PermGen space is especially heap area which is separated from main memory, and it's well known for storing all the static content in this section. Apart from that, we have application metadata. So application metadata, that is required by JVM to perform various operations. So that metadata is nothing but the data which describes about data. So to get information, we need metadata. So, but the biggest disadvantage of PermGen is that it contains a limited size, which leads to an out of memory error. So the default size of PermGen space is 64 MB on 32 bit JVM and 82 MB on 64 bit version. Due to this, JVM had to change the size of its memory frequently by performing garbage collection, which is a costly operation. So as the memory size is limited only to 64 MB for 32 bit and 82 MB, so the main drawback is that frequently garbage collections had needed to be done in case of PermGen space area, because the size is less and it's performed as the size gets full, memory size, that automatically we need to perform the garbage collection. But that was the frequency of performing garbage collection was too quick or too number of times. So as garbage collection is a costly operation, it certainly affected because we need to do frequent garbage collections. So it may be the CPU cycle clocks and times must have been increased due to this, which is affecting the performance. So to overcome all these drawbacks, the Metaspace came into the picture. So we saw entirely the various aspects of Metaspace, the differences between Metaspace and PermGen space, how the area is stored into heap, what is about the young generation, old generation, and the PermGen space that forms the non-heap area, and what are the basically issues. So basically memory and was the main issue, and garbage collection needed to be performed frequently, which led to the introduction of Metaspace. So after that, a lot of research was done, and we have Metaspace in Java 8 and above versions. So this video was all about related to Metaspace and its internal working and its key aspects. So do keep liking, subscribing, hashtag #meet, more to come on you on other related Java topics. Bye for now.